Yeah, Smart Wargames here. Let's check out a Matrix Slytherin game that was, so far as I know, not seen on YouTube at least. Campaigns on the Danube, 1805 and 1809. Napoleonic Wars, turn-based operational war game, resolving on the situation there was Austria, which invaded the ally of France, Bavaria, which then resulted in the intervention of French with the Battle of Wagram and crushing the Austrian army. Yeah, you can get it currently here on the Slytherin store. I'm using currently Windows 10, might be the same for 11 before we hit the game. Yeah, installation was fine. No modifications needed or whatever. And this game was even updated a couple of years ago. The original game is already somewhat older. And first I will show you the manual. Pause the video if you want. It's 38 pages. And then we will check the content. Not really proficient in this game. Channel income is good recently, and usually investing it in new games, especially games never showcased. Because I'm pretty sure there are also some others that might were sitting in the Matrix store and considering a game, but somehow not finding information, thinking about a purchase. And yeah, as usual, I will try to give you an overview of the game, what to expect. But the ultimate decision is then up to you, if it is yours or not. Good, that is a manual. As I mentioned, the game starts and installs without problems on modern OS. One thing I've noticed is screen resolution. It shows up all resolutions that are available on my screen. I guess it is fetching it from Windows or whatever, but you can't select them. At least I was not able to select all those resolutions. The highest resolution I was able to select is 1366 by 768. Which, if you run a high resolution in your Windows, will result in a window. Might be not that immersive, not that great to play. So I currently lowered my Windows resolution to this one in order to have a full screen experience. You can play this game Hot Seat PBM from the Coalition and from France. There is 7 scenarios, I will go through them. Pause the video if you want to read the description. And yeah, even if you run in this resolution, you need somehow to get rid of your taskbar, otherwise you can't hit the start button. So it is a bit finicky, but you might figure it out. Yeah, for example, use this taskbar eliminator. You could, I guess, even lower your Windows resolution further to see the screen and then launch in 1366. Good. We are already in game, yeah. Controls are pretty good, game is fluid. We see the map. Interface, yeah, it is a turn-based game. But somehow it appears to me it is a Vigo game, yeah, that you give orders, then conduct the turn, and then those orders are executed. For me, this would qualify as a Vigo game, which is a nice thing. I'm a big supporter of Vigo operational games, where everything is happening at the same time and not somebody is pulling off moves while the other side is sitting and doing nothing. You might give orders and the operational situation changes. That was common cause. So yeah, to the interface, you have some map filters, like supply is a thing in this game, which is represented by those chits. You can remove force in order to see what is, for example, in Ulm. A finder, if you look for a specific commander or unit, what happened, I guess, In this scenario, the Austrians under General Mack have advanced across Bavaria. Bavaria was an ally of the French. But the French are coming. So do the Russians. No reinforcements and thieves, as this is blank. There's some intelligence reports. Yeah, there's a fog of war setting. You probably saw it in the setup screen. You can also play with hardcore fog of war rules, where you basically don't see enemy armies, but you only get reports. That is a nice thing, not often done. So need to watch those reports and guess where the enemy might be. Yeah, save load, settings. And a strategic map. Good. Yeah, I'm not really that educated on Napoleonic warfare. I mean, we know that we are... Okay, here are the French. Only we have an army at Ulm. Check this out. Under General Mack. With a lot of other commanders and units. And they have a stance. Yeah, you can change the stance. And the urgency, and then you can send orders. Yeah. From what I figure out, you basically select, let's say we want to move from Ulm, probably meet the French in the north, to Gingen. Let's select. Good, let's leave Max command here, but you see the French already approaching Gingen. Kienmeier, move to Gingen immediately. French approaching. If I can handle it now. Retreat point is no retreat. Supply depot is here at Munich with the army. Engage if you see enemy. Regular urgency. Do a forced. And yeah, bring your units with you. Good. Wernick, same. Reich, follow them. So you first need to give orders to your units, and it depends if they even arrive. That was a big problem, of course, to this very day, if orders will be arriving in time and how they will be interpreted. Good. Logic. Follow them. Reminds me a bit of Scourge of War, where you also basically fill out orders and then send them. Good, and Muck, that is those individual units. Those commanders are in charge of, and Muck will stay here at Munich or in the vicinity of Ulm. Yeah, the Russians, let's see, we might bring. That is already VFS. Ah, that is, he is a commander, okay. We don't have other commanders here. Okay, let's see if it works out now better. But you can give some orders to the army command, like burn depot if the enemy is approaching, set up a hospital, that might be an idea. Yeah, we already basically set this up, but yeah, you can set supply and even comms. Some interesting ideas, and we saw already how the resolve works. For me, that qualifies as a Vigo. Yeah, everything is moving at the same time, that is nice. We might set up our hospital at Munich for the wounded. Yeah, and the playback is basically also Vigo style. Every player can watch the playback, which we will do now. They're already captured. Gingen, so we are approaching no enemy. Good, they have received their orders. I guess there's also a possibility that they won't receive their orders. Yeah, except let's assume Muck is sitting here and one of his commanders is sitting in Augsburg. And in between their enemies, those guys might not receive their orders and nothing happens. That was a thing back in the days as well. But everybody received orders. We set up a hospital at Munich. And they should now move out together with their units on a forced march in order to oppose the enemy in the vicinity of Gingen. But the French are faster. I like it. I mean, it is sure the interface is a bit finicky, but I think once you figure it out and you like especially this theater, which I don't think is that often covered, as not in this detailed way. Yeah, they're already at Gingen, not sure if it is a good idea, but we already gave those orders. I guess this is also a game where you need to watch out giving orders, like in Scourge of War or other games. If you hand out new orders, it might screw with your units. Yeah, that is coming more close to true commanding. A lot of those games, you're basically moving chits in an instant. And imagine even if you wouldn't have, I mean, there is some hardcore mode where you don't see even the enemy units and then need to stick to intelligence reports. And currently you wouldn't know even, I don't know if why we are seeing them. We play with Fog of War, I guess it's because they're in the vicinity. But there's even a more hardcore Fog of War where you basically know nothing. And you need to check intelligence reports and something might come in. Enemy in the vicinity of Gingen reported. Might be true, might be not true. Enemy army elements, armies, core-sized elements, whatever. Yeah, the Russians. I don't know, do we want to send them? I guess the Russians coming to our aid. There's even a second Russian army here in the corner. Lisa. Is that Russian? Check this guy's out. Yeah, with right click you can shuffle. And we have a reserve force near Wien. I guess you can move them on their own, yeah. But without a commander. Yeah, Sure, you have a lot of options here, no doubt, but let's see how this combat will resolve, because we want to see how combat looks in this game. The French are reinforcing the position. While our army's not the fastest, but first elements might now arrive. And it seems like they're pushing the French out. French are retreating for the time being. It seems like they're not on a setting, they're on a screen setting or something. And it is raining. But there are units in the same hex. We will see how this will resolve. Ah, okay. So that is how combat looks like. Good. Let's try out an escalating assault. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad for us, but I mean, they have probably the big advantage positioning themselves there in the buildings. Slight command failure, that is also a thing. Some command values being calculated. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad for us. Well, it's not over, but we made some progress. Question is if we want to call in the Russians. I guess we won't. Let's assemble them in near Raubing. But that is too big distance for a forced march. Yeah, supply, they might take it from the vicinity of Eckmühl. Regensberg might be also their retreat point. Or Krems. Okay. And those French reserves. French reserves, Austrian reserves. They're attached to Mack. Yeah, we will keep them here. And those guys will go to Latau. That will work out. Receive supplies from Pilsen. Might be also their retreat point. Yeah. Looks like order looks fine. Okay, let's watch how this comet will resolve. Okay, we captured some French supplies. Seems like Gingen is now ours. We could push forward, which would require new orders. We could give Kinmeyer new orders. Well, let's see how this works out. Looks like they're still engaging, that is good. I guess if you set them on an engaged stance, they might pick fights on their own. Which is true, yeah? I mean, you are not in micromanagement control here, but you give orders, set those orders, and your commanders are supposed to handle the situation somehow. And we have a battle. Wernick has been shattered. Where did this happen? So it took some losses, but resulted in a victory. But we have some smaller proxy battles here in the vicinity of Gingen. Some French cavalry spotted at Pappenheim. And let's check the Russians out. I guess they don't even receive the orders yet. Yeah, because otherwise there would be a pop-up. Kutuzov received orders. So far they didn't receive even their orders, so it could be that there is a messenger on the way. When he will arrive, we will see. But yeah, what I like is this floaty feeling. That is, at least for me, that is way superior over this manage every single shit in like a hive mind. That's also what I like about Scorch of War, you're giving orders out. Without having this confidence or this insurance that everything will work out exactly as you, as the Supreme Commander envisioned it. Okay, we might give Jelacic new orders to advance towards the north, seize this crossroads, as you might then need to push towards Pappenheim as something is going on there. And this is completely open here. I don't think the Russians will receive those orders fast enough. So let's seize those crossroads here, and then we might see what we do if we might advance one element towards Elwangen. But perhaps the French will come up with a huge army and everything's over. Who knows? Good. Let's go here. Retreat point is Gingen. Yeah, that should be fine. Engage, regular. Send the orders. Hope he will arrive them, he will receive them. While the rest will assemble in Gingen. What the heck is Wernick doing? Wernick pulled off some flank move. Wernick. Jimmy, what are you... Yeah, perhaps we need to wait. Objective Augsburg. Ah, he retreated from battle. Is that correct? Werner, can't remember giving you orders to Augsburg. Yeah, he's retreating, okay. You know what? That is perhaps not even a bad idea if the French are pushing in here. Okay, go to Augsburg. And rally up. Yeah, I guess in one, Werneck was crushed. Was that the message? Yeah, it seems like in one battle here in this vicinity, Werneck received something that pressed him to retreat. So always set up your retreat spots, otherwise those armies might run around. It seems like the French are not done here. They bring in reinforcements. Yeah, I really like how the battles resolve here. There's not a single battle and then it's over after 5 seconds. But it feels really like a clash where people throwing in forces. That, I must say, is great. Yeah, sure, the interface, everything is quite... Some of this movement, yeah, but I guess that is the commanders deciding to do some switching, whatever. I will leave it to the commanders. Hey, Beyond. Hey, Smart War Games. Interesting game you got today. Yeah, I got some quite interesting games, never seen before. I think we have minimum 2 games. I have 2 games planned that were never seen before, including this one here. Sure, it is really something for enthusiasts. But I like some of those ideas, yeah. Like communication or this order system. In the beginning, this order system looks finicky, but then if you play a couple of turns, you think this is pretty good. It's giving you exactly what you read from those books about the real stuff, where orders were sent to somebody and you think, will those guys arrive? Will they even come? There was no WhatsApp chat or whatever. Hey, yeah, I'm coming, no problem. You send out orders and imagine you're a commander sitting there and you have no confirmation. Will an army, will an element arrive in order to assist you? Yeah? And there was, for example, a battle at... which one was it? Yeah, I can't remember, but there were several battles that were lost because people didn't arrive, for whatever reasons. Perhaps they stick to orders. For example, Napoleon was quite notorious for allowing his commanders, his generals, his field marshals, very little flexibility. He was not a fan of initiative. He allowed them little initiative. If he sent out orders, he basically asked those commanders to stick to those orders almost by the letter. And however, the situation might change in hours or days. And I think there was one commander that was quite denounced, which basically did what he was asked for, but then was somehow considered as being one of the main reasons why the battle was lost, but he did basically what Napoleon asked him. He was basically a good commander. And I guess those values might be also here in this game between the commanders. Some commanders might take the initiative, others might stick to the order by the letter. Yeah, I mean, did Jelacic already receive the orders? I don't think so. We didn't receive information that, but we have a battle coming up here. I struggle sometimes to tell from this screen who is facing who. But that must be Jelacic, and I think he's facing inferior elements. Not gonna sell them. Yeah, it's not that inferior. Might be quite costly. But they are withdrawing. When a force is withdrawing, a frontal assault, but we took quite heavy losses, but so did the French. And this should be a victory for us. Yeah. I mean, if a force is withdrawing, a frontal assault is not even a bad idea. This might basically put the nail into them. Yeah. But Wernick, man, he's retreating here. I might give him new orders to go to Ingolstadt in order to cover our flank. Wernick. Ingolstadt, here. The retreat point is Ingolstadt, so no retreat. Supply depot will be there. What is that? Ingolstadt. The vicinity of Ingolstadt. Oh, that is Ingolstadt, okay. Defend, march regular, send orders to Ingolstadt. Looks good. Really like this order system. Which for those Napoleonic games, but it should be also basically for other games. Let's see if he receives even the orders. See what our superior is, Mac is doing here. Supply control. Yeah, let's switch supply control to computer supply. Let the computer handle it if somebody is in need of supplies. And yeah, burn depot, no. Don't change anything. Communication center is currently operating, so there's no need to change it. Really like this game. I was surprised. I think this will be some, especially judging by the interface, but doesn't look too bad. Once you figure out. It might be fun as a multiplayer. Here's to me as AI is switching out units. I don't know what they're doing here because they... Ah, Wernick received his orders. You see how long it took? One or two turns. Yeah, and the Russians didn't receive their orders this very day. Somebody, I don't know, can you see those messengers? I guess not. Yeah, like in reality, you don't know what happened to your messenger. He might sitting somewhere eating. Might took the wrong way. Somebody killed him. You will never know. I mean, you might send several messengers, but still. I mean, they took 1 or 2 days to cover this area. You see, even Kev, oh, it takes them 1 day to move this area. So even if you have a fast messenger, he will take a week or something to arrive there. Okay, now we are attacked by the French. Yeah, let's defend. But should be fine. And they're frontal assaulting, which might be brutal if we are defending together with RT. Because in frontal assault, they might be rather struggle to use their RT. But we're taking losses. Which might be because of the weather. I think it is raining, which might be that we can't use our RT and our guns properly. But I think we managed to hold. Yeah, I think it is raining. Raining might make a frontal assault more effective. Yeah, we held the position. Okay. Yeah, enough. This should give you an idea of the game. Rays, like what I see here, something like some, if you like, games like Scourge of War that really focus on command and control, which it is indeed for me also often an absolutely neglected element. Sure, we all like the sport game experience, but I think we need way more games here, like Scourge of War, like this, like Flashpoint campaigns. Games that really focus on command and control and give you this, what I call, floaty feeling. Yeah, can't be sure. Okay, but what I can show you is perhaps the other scenarios. I don't know if there's a different map. Let's, for example, check the 1809 time frame. How this looks. But the same map, I guess. Yeah, okay. So everything seems to be resolving around this. Yeah. Danube AO. Sure, the situations will change. But that is basically your map. Yeah, that is your map. It's different operational situations, historical, and I guess some what if. Yeah, morale, fatigue, stress. Give them a rest day. Can move the interface, that is also, perhaps that is even better. Nice idea. Yeah, not bad. I'm pretty sure this game might find some that are very interested in it. I mean, it runs quite on a high price. I talked about it several times. Okay, $18.99, and on a sale, I think it is fine. Yeah, for 10, some enthusiasts might hit the button. I think there are other games that cost something like 40, 50 or whatever, despite being very old and only appealing perhaps to some specialists, where I think the price policy is a bit. Could be updated, but I think that price is fine. Yeah. Normal 18 and 9 on a sale. If you dive seriously into this, this might occupy you for some time. And comes very... we played a ton of war games here on the channel, and there's a lot of war games that feel very similar. I must say this war game feels unique and comes with some gameplay ideas that I want to see in other games. There's another title called Guns, and that is World War One focus. You might check it out. I tried to acquire it via our Matrix Littering Corporation, but those guys can't find any keys for those older games. They absolutely don't have a program for that. Because usually people only want to stream the newer games. But I think it is still worth to check this out. Still holds a position. Yeah, okay, let's see what I will come up next with. Give me a couple of minutes to hit to establish my line of communication, and then I come back. Good hunting.